Hello, I'm Xavier Delay, Communication Manager for John Cockerill Defence, and I'm happy to be here with you to present the MOU we signed with MILREM Robotics. I think it's a very good collaboration because John Cockerill Defence and MILREM Robotics have the know-how and the experience to design and to develop the robotic armored vehicle of tomorrow. So it's a very good opportunity for us to work in the future. For John Cockerill Defence, we give the turrets, the weapon station system, and MILREM give the vehicle, the robotic.
Hi, my name is Kuldar Värsi and I'm the CEO of MILREM Robotics. And we are very pleased to be at the IDEX demonstrating something really new and innovative. So behind me you can see the one of the very first robotic combat vehicles in the world. And we are very pleased to make this collaboration with exactly John Cockerill, with whom we have found the perfect match, where the lethality system by John Cockerill and the very advanced mobility system by MILREM Robotics will provide very good system for the armies to basically add the capabilities and firepower to their existing units. We believe that the robotics is the future of the warfare. And it will be always a combination of manned and unmanned. So manned and unmanned teaming will be the main keyword for the next 10 to 20 years. And in the robotics, moving up on the size classes. So we have small vehicle teamies already for years. Now we have developed the Type X, which moves it to the level of the infantry fighting vehicles and main battle tanks. So it's a wingman for the infantry fighting vehicles and main battle tanks. It will never replace them, but it will add additional firepower and the capabilities. First of all, what is important is that this is by design autonomous systems. So it's equipped with many different sensors in very different places, and it is designed to be controlled autonomously, mobility part of it. It's hybrid, so we have electrical motors which are in the back and which are moving the vehicle. They are powered by the batteries, and the batteries are charged by the diesel generator, giving the extended range up to 600 kilometers with one fuel tank. And the speed is really, really something as well. It's 80 kilometers per hour on road, 50 kilometers per hour off road. So the mobility of this vehicle can overmatch any modern infantry fighting vehicle today. It's obviously absolutely unmanned, so there will be no human inside the vehicle, never. And it's prepared for very different lethality systems, like 30 to 50 millimeter autocannon, missile systems, anti-aircraft systems, etc., etc. You can control it over the control station designed by MILREM Robotics, which is either placed inside the infantry fighting vehicle or APC, or it is used in the stationary control or command post. You need the training to do that, and in the MILREM our engineers is working to make it as simple to the end user as possible, but still special training is obviously needed. The mobility part is designed to cope the very difficult terrain up to 50 kilometers per hour. We are using rubber tracks. Our track manufacturer is Sosi, very good and reliable partner in that sense. And it's armored, so the base armor is level 1, but it can be upgraded with add-on armor. And the weapon system is always up to level 4. So the weapon system is the critical system for this vehicle. So even if the mobility is not possible anymore, then you still can operate the weapon system and use it. The engine is in the back, so the heat is collected to the back side of the vehicle, so that makes front end heat signature extremely low. So it's low from the height perspective and low from the heat signature perspective, so it's very difficult to detect that kind of vehicle on the terrain. There are many different sensors, lidars, radars, cameras, IR cameras, thermal cameras, ENS systems. So it's really complex mix of sensors to make this kind of vehicle move autonomously on the off-road environment. And what is important as well, as this vehicle is developed by the contract from the Saudi customer, then it's especially developed for very challenging heat conditions like in this region are. So that is considered when designing the cooling system and the system itself. What I have seen is that John Cockerill as a company has a very good understanding that in future the robotic systems will have very important role. And using the weapon system on top of a robotic vehicle like this one is much more challenging than on the traditional manned vehicle. So, and John Cockerill understands that very well and is moving towards the robotic combat systems in general. So there is very good match in a sense that we complement each other in terms of the technologies and capabilities, but at the same time, we share the same vision how the modern warfare will look alike. So this memo covers as well the intention to work together on the European development programs jointly as well, to really develop in the Europe the most advanced and modern robotic systems. We are now finalizing the phase one, where we designed and built the prototype vehicle, and now we are running the mobility tests, which have been very successful. We have reached top speed 87 kilometers per hour. Autonomous mode, and next phase will be the next iteration of the development and already preparation for the industrialization. Current plan is that by the end of the year 2024 we have industrialized system which can be already manufactured in series. So as I mentioned, actually this development is done under the contract from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia.